Dear Flow Fellows, I would like to welcome you all to our How-To series. My name is Ricardo Böhme and I am working as an application engineer for our flow measurement products at SICK. Today I have our FlowSICK 100 FlayXT with us. The topic of today's How-To video is how to calculate and to adjust the wetted path length. But what is the wetted path length? Both sender and receiver units need to be inserted into the pipeline. There's a distance which depends on the nozzle length, of the gasket thickness, of the wall thickness, and if you have a retractable version, of course the ball valve length. This distance is our wetted path length. So we need to calculate that we know how deep we need to push our FlayXT into the pipeline. Considering that, our first step will be the determination of all mentioned dimensions. Those lengths need to be very accurate, especially the wall thickness must be determined accurately to 0.1 mm. So if you have all geometric dimensions in place, we can start our next step, which will be the calculation. Therefore, we will need to open up FlowGate. So we will need an offline device, FlowSICK 100 FlayXT, and we will connect to it. Press on login. Now you will face this screen. Go to the right and to the wizard parameter modification. There you will find the geometry calculator. Open that one up. And now we can choose our device type, which can be found in the left-hand corner. So we can choose between a cross duct or a probe version. In our example, we will use the cross duct. Here's a slider where we can choose the number of paths. For instance, if we have a dual path, and in our example, we will use the single path. You can also choose with another slider if the path is retractable or not. If it is, the system will add a length for the ball valve. Here we will insert our measured dimensions, for instance the length of the ball valve, our wall thickness, the nominal nozzle angle beta, our circumference of the pipeline. So in this example we will use a 72-inch pipeline or DN1800, our gasket thickness and also the length of our nozzles. We will click on calculate transducer distance. And now we have to click on calculate parameter values. And now the system has calculated our wetted path length. Please check those lengths about their plausibility. Write the wetted path length down because we will need it later for the mechanical adjustment. So our next step will be the mechanical part. So I would like to explain to you which parts are necessary on the FlayXT. So for the next step, I have placed the FlayXT more in the center of the table that you can see what I would like to explain to you. So these are the necessary mechanical parts. Here we have two screws. The bigger one is the pipe screw fitting and the smaller one is the self-cutting ring. So before we get started, this pipe screw fitting will be tightened with a torquer wrench, so with a torquer of 150 newton meter. And the self-cutting ring will be tightened tight with 1.25 turns. So please note, after adjusting and tightening the self-cutting ring, you can not remove it anymore. So first it is cut and you have done something wrong. The master and slave unit of the FlowSICK 100 FlayXT needs to be completely removed and replaced. So now that is clear which screw needs to be tightened, we will start to adjust our calculated wetted path length. We will measure this with a length gauge and please ensure that you have a tolerance of plus minus 1 mm if you do so. After adjusting the welded path length, we can start by tighten the pipe screw fitting with a torquer wrench and a torquer of 150 Newton meter. After you have checked everything for plausibility and double checked the adjusted welded path length, we can start it by tighten the self-cutting ring. So therefore we will need to counter it with a jaw wrench at the pipe screw fitting, and we will need to tight it 1.25 turns. After that is done, now we have adjusted our welded path length and we can start loosening the self-cutting ring again for transportation. Please do not touch anymore the pipe screw fitting because that is not necessary, and we only need to loosen the self-cutting ring and then we can retract the whole unit again. Please keep in mind that for a cross-duct version you have two transducers, two sender and receiver units, and the procedure that was shown in the instructions needs to be also done for the other unit. We have reached the end of our how-to video with today's topic, how to calculate and adjust the welded path length of the Flowsig 100 Flare XT. If you have any open questions, please refer also to the operation instructions and manuals, get in touch with your SIG subsidiary, or leave a comment in the comment section below. Thank you for choosing SIG, and we will see us next time.